Hi players, today I have a special guest for you. Coach Maria will discuss what it means to be an impact player. This topic will be of an interest to those of you who have aspirations to play in high performance or colleges and universities level, but really this is something that you cannot just turn into overnight. Being an impact player is something that you have to work on since you are very little. Do listen to what Coach Maria has to say. This information will be very useful about specific positions, the positions that you play, and you can reach out to her on Instagram or Twitter. I will leave all the links down below. Give her a follow, and I can't wait to hear what Coach Maria has to say.
Hey guys, Coach Maria here, just checking in to the Soccer Fundamentals. Coach Max put this together and just wanted me to come on and speak a little bit about what you could do to stay active during this this crisis we're going through, COVID-19. I mean, as a soccer player and just kind of as an athlete, everybody's kind of feeling the struggle and feeling, you know, just being not being able to do much is just work out by yourself and try and keep active. So for me, I've been keeping active as much as possible by working out, doing some skills. I've been posting a lot on my Instagram and on my Twitter account, all different workouts with and without the ball. I know it's not game consistency. It's not, you know, playing at that high tempo, high speed. You might not have an opponent, you know, because you're not with your team, but you need to stay active. It's number one. If you think about it, if we come back May, June, you're going to go right into your season basically. So there's not going to be a lot of time for you to come back on the field, get fit, and then go into a season. Most coaches, and I'm hoping what everybody is taking away from this is you're going to come back, you might have a couple weeks, and then you're right in. So if you're coming back unfit, I mean, you're only prone to injuries by 90%. I mean, the injury rates for a player not fit training and playing at the high level compared to an athlete who is fit is tremendous. So definitely need to be able to keep up with it. And honestly, there's really no excuses. If you are an elite athlete and you play in these high leagues, OPDL or even rep, for instance, you have to be training. It doesn't take long. You don't need a lot of time. If your training is twice a week, for an hour and a half, like you would on your normal team, you should be doing that as much as you can or that you need to for yourself. You only know yourself. You only can push yourself. You know, your coach, your technical director, people at the club, your teammates aren't with you right now, right? It's mostly just yourself. So you need to find that drive and push it. The topic I want to cover today is, obviously I would for myself, I would film everything I can right now, all my touches, all my workouts, everything, so that way you can watch it back and start building a database, not only on yourself with content, but just on yourself to have something to look back on. Maybe you work out Monday and it's Friday and you go back and watch Monday's workout and repeat it. And let's say you do 60 touches in 1 minute. Maybe now you're going to get 65 in 1 minute. So always watch it. I mean, I have an iPhone. That's it. I just film off my iPhone. I have a tripod that I film off of. I don't get fancy. I'm not one of these big techie with all this nice fancy equipment. I just literally get my phone. I'll show you now. I literally get my phone and I just film. See, I just film all my workouts. All my workouts are in here, and then I'll just upload them there. I'll just go back in and see, and I've made a separate file called COVID-19. So I go in and I watch all my workouts that I've done. We've been in lockdown almost 14 days. I've worked out 8 of the 14 days. Obviously, you need rest in between. You don't want to overdo it, but there's no excuses. I mean, I'm a coach. I need to stay fit for my athletes, and you're a player that needs to stay fit for your career. So I think that was something I definitely wanted to talk about on this. You know, you could always message me or Coach Max for Soccer Fundamentals if you need help with activities and drills and workouts. I mean, we're two people in the game that have great knowledge on, you know, how to better yourself and better your career. So definitely use us, and we're here to help, right? We want to be able to help athletes get to that next level, and this is a chance for you to see what you're all about, right? It's, you're not on a routine where, you know, you go to school and then you go to training at night, or you are on the weekend, you might have a match, or you might be traveling for a showcase or a tournament, right? This is kind of like You're waiting around, right? We're all not doing much, but now that you're not doing much, it's a perfect time for you to get a ball. All you really need to be productive and do soccer fundamentals is a ball. If you don't have a ball, a tennis ball, a small ball, something, a ball and a cone. That's it. You don't need to get fancy. You don't need a lot of space. So people who don't allow players to train inside, obviously find a little patch of grass or the street outside. If you have a little spot in your house, your basement, your garage, your living room, whatever your parents, your guardian will allow you to have, all you need to do is just simple little touches. Obviously, take that and then go for a run. If you can go to the park and kick the ball around there, or take the ball, dribble it on your run. Wherever your space allows you, create that workout based around your environment. Adapt. I mean, there's no excuse. Today it rained, I trained in the basement. Tomorrow it might rain, I'll train in the basement. If it's not raining, I'll train outside. So there's no excuses for what you have to do. So I guess that's my message to all of you is don't really have an excuse for different things. I mean, you need to get your workout in and you need to keep busy. And it's tough, right? We're all in the same boat. Don't think you're alone in this. We're all in this together. So definitely want to be able to share that. Another thing I wanted to share is just a little piece of advice for all players that are listening to this. And just talk a little bit about how to get noticed for that next level. I mean, so I deal with elite athletes every day. It's not the only thing I do, but it's kind of what I like to do. I like to work with players who want to be elite athletes, either stay in Canada, go on a scholarship, go over to England or Europe, or go somewhere on an American scholarship in the United States. So I try to prepare athletes all throughout any age group to have that mindset to say, okay, listen, you can get there. We can push you. It's just what you want, right? It's how much you want. So just speaking a little bit around how to get to that next level if you're in each position. So I'm going to go through different positions and kind of what a coach like myself or a scout might look for in certain positions. I mean, a lot of the things you're going to hear from a goalie to a center back to a wing back, so the outside defenders to a winger, to center midfield to a striker, or a forward. I mean, most of them are going to be the same. There's some key characteristics of certain players, but most of them are the same. First of all, you have to be an impact player. Not even you touching the ball, because as you know, if you're playing 90 minutes of soccer, you're lucky to touch the ball 2 to 3 minutes in a game, right? So it's those 88, 87 minutes what you do off of the ball. So for me, it's an impact. You making those runs. This is for all field players, so everybody, center backs, full backs, wingers, center mids, strikers. It's those runs you make to either break a line. So if you think about it, here's a line. If you can break that line, right? So if you're a defender, how you can get past their forward, right, would be the first line for you. So things like that are important. That impact player that you're gonna come on and just command, be commanding, talk, communications. Key. I mean, if you have a scout sitting on the sideline and you're on the pitch and you're playing, you're always asking for the ball or you're kind of directing, you're that leader. Coaches love that. Coaches love that for any platform that you want to go to. So that's definitely key for any position for me and obviously that impact player. Wing backs, so your full backs now as your defenders. The game's changing if you look at any professional team. I mean, I just spent 2 weeks in England in January, and the full backs were getting up the field. So you have to have pace. If you're a full back, you play right or left defender. When you get to that 11v11 pitch, there's no excuses for you not to get forward. I mean, coaches still here haven't adapted to that style yet. I see some coaches haven't. But if you're a player and you want to make an impact, getting up and down the field and having pace, overlapping that outside winger, or you going up and taking their spot so they can push forward and get into that forward role is huge. So getting forward for a wing back is number one. Center back has to be deadly in the air, has to command the pitch, has to have a good back line. If you play with three, you play with four, some play with five. You have to be that key person. The next thing for a center back. You have to be able to have a good relationship with your goalie. If you're a center back and you're not best friends with your goalie, you're in the wrong position. You have to be able to be this with your goalie. You have to know each other, you have to work off each other, because it's you two commanding the field, right? You kind of see everything forward, right? So you can move parts. So definitely, for me, that's what I always tell my center back. As a goalie, I mean, obviously for goalie, as you know, you use your feet more, so your feet have to be perfect. Never mind your hands for now. Be all what you're doing during this break is using your feet to get better, because a lot of distribution comes through you. I mean, if there's a goal kick or we play back to the goalie, they have to be able to distribute the ball. So playing with your feet is number one for a goalie. Obviously, having good coordination would be second. Being able to jump and catch the ball, save the ball, but feet are so important. So that would be my advice to you. Wingers, so in the midfield, definitely trying to get forward and back. I mean, you're playing two roles, so you're getting forward in the attack, you're dropping as a defender, so you're up and down the pitch. For me, as a winger, seeing a winger who could cross both with their left and right foot is number one. No excuses for players not to be good with their left and their right. I mean, so many players I see put on their soccer profile or I see soccer resumes come through and they're like, yeah, I'm left footed and right footed. Then we go out to see them and, you know, they can't kick with their left foot into the box. So service from you is important, from the wing. So definitely for a winger over this break, trying to work on distribution, so just that pass, using those laces, using those inside of the feet, striking the ball, so that way you can have good service into the box, and obviously pace. So go out and have a couple runs, get a little quicker. And when I talk about running, I'm not saying go out and run 10K, 15K. As a player, based off your position, sprinting is so important. Everybody always thinks doing laps is always great for players. So just make sure you know a little bit about what to be doing on what day. Not just going out for a run is for 10K is important for an athlete and for a soccer player. So definitely make sure you know what you're doing in regards to that. If not, ask Coach Max or myself, and we would be able to help you. So next position, definitely the heart of the team. I mean, I went from a center back to a center midfield, fell in love with it, and now I love working with center midfields. I feel we have a lot of center midfields in the game, but what makes them dynamic, first of all, is find out what kind of a center midfield you are, if you like to attack more or you like to distribute and kind of sit back and watch the play. If you're a center midfield, watch Andrea Pirlo. Players and coaches and people in the soccer industry can debate me, but for me, he's the best center back, center midfield of all time. Sorry, he's just world class. He's just so smart. The vision on the ball is insane. Obviously, I'm a little biased towards that too because I'm Italian, but I mean, I would love to debate anyone on that. So for me, it's just his vision in the game. He sees things before the ball even comes to his feet, and that's one of his quotes, right? Is he knows what he's going to do before the ball gets to the feet. You have to be creative. You have to be able to turn, play back to your defenders, your outside midfield, your outside defenders, or play forward, right? Into your striker, into your forward, break those lines, right? You have to be that key player. Obviously, center midfields cover the most distance in a game, but you have to be able to go side to side, so left and right, up and down, right? So you're in that little diamond. So quick little movements for center midfields are important. Distribution so important. Being able to strike from distance. Also, I see this a lot of the time. We're losing being able to strike from distance. Players from like 13 onwards should be able to hit a 30-yard ball at goal. So that's something I would definitely work for. Last but not least, obviously, is those strikers and those forwards, those number nines, some number tens. So important as well. But your roles are changing. I mean, now you're starting to get, you're moving side to side instead of just sitting, winning the ball, turning, and shooting on goal or going to goal, right? Your role's changing. Sometimes players will play into you. You hold the ball and then you look to distribute as well. So a striker or forward's role is always changing. So you have to be able to be dynamic. Obviously, you have to be smart to play off of your team, right? If your team likes to play, if your team likes to play that long ball over the top, you have to be quick on the receiving end to stay onside, go in behind the defender's back, win it, and go to goal. Or if your team likes to keep possession, win the ball, hold the ball up, then turn, and then go to goal. Obviously, for you, striking's number one. So get outside, find a pitch. Even if it's not an 11v11 size goal, go find a 5v5, 7v7, 9v9, whatever net you can find, and just go strike the ball. And especially for you, hitting with distance is important. Anyways, I don't want to take too much of your time, so hopefully I answered some questions on soccer fundamentals. Hopefully COVID-19 ends, but obviously we'll wait with the government and see what that says because health is number one. If you want to reach out to me and chat more, my Instagram and Twitter handles soccer Coach Maria Soccer. My email's coachmariasoccer@gmail.com. Max will put all the details below. Thank you for tuning in. It's been a real honor to talk to you. Have a good night. Bye-bye.